So we're going to make x the subject of this formula. So what we could do to start with, we're just going to write the left-hand side as the right-hand side, right-hand side as the left-hand side, so that the x is on the left-hand side. So we've got square root of x plus 2 is equal to 3 multiplied by g minus 5. And then we want to really get rid of the square root, don't we? So we just square both sides. So that gives us that x plus 2 is equal to all of the right-hand side squared. So that means we've got 9 times all of g minus 5 squared. Note it's not g squared minus 5 squared. That would be something completely different. And actually, we're nearly there now because we want to make x the subject. So all we need to do is subtract 2 from both sides, and we hopefully have our answer. So 9 times g minus 5 squared subtract 2. Obviously, we want to check that this is correct. And a simple way of doing this is to look back at the original formula and substitute in a value for x and find g, and then check that our answer gives the original x value. So I'll show you what I mean. Now, because of this square root, it's going to be a lot easier if we choose a value of x that will make that square root a nice whole number. So I'm going to choose x equal to 7. So that gives me, just looking at the first line where we've got the question, we've got 3g minus 5 is the square root of x plus 2, isn't it? So that's the square root of 7 plus 2, which is the square root of 9, which is 3. So if 3 times g minus 5 is equal to 3, let's just write that down so we can see what we're doing, then g minus 5 is 1, isn't it? So g is equal to 6. So what we're saying is that given the original formula, if x is 7, then g is 6. What we want to do to check our answer is to make sure that when we substitute in the value of g of 6, that we do end up getting x is 7. If we do, then it means there's a good chance our answer is right. It's not saying it's definitely right, but there's a good chance it is right. It at least will work for this one value. So let's have a look at what happens. Let's give ourselves a bit of space first of all. Right, so we're going to take our answer and substitute in the value g is 6. So let's see what x turns out to be. So x is going to be 9 multiplied by 6 minus 5 squared subtract 2. So that's 9 multiplied by 1 squared subtract 2. So that's 9 minus 2, which is 7. In other words, it looks as if we've got the right answer.